Hello and welcome to another episode from the Water's Edge. You catch up with us today on the way to another session and bit of filming. Now we got up nice and early this morning to hopefully do a bit of perch fishing. And the lake we're heading to is a lake that we've fished before and we have caught perch. We're not really fishing for them. And if we're going to be completely honest, we don't know how big they go in there, but we've had a couple of fish about the pound and a half mark. And as I said, catching fish of that size while not really targeting just get us that seed in our brains thinking, could there be a real big fish in there? So we're going to have a little investigation today, a little bit of a step into the unknown, but hopefully in today's session, if anything, we'll show you plenty of tips and a little bit of advice on how to catch some perch, because they're not always the easiest fish to catch. They can be quite finicky, and there's a couple of little things you can do to try and get yourself that extra bonus fish. So we've got about 5 or so minutes of driving left. And then once we're there, we'll set the gear up and we'll catch up with you in a bit. Okay, we're ready to start the session now. We've got all the gear set up. So I think first of all, just a couple of quick talking points to show you what we're doing. First of all, why we've picked this peg. Now, this is the peg we fished before where we had a few perch from. So initially, just use that as the first bit of information and come back down till we know where they'll be. Second of all, we've got a little channel to the left, an overhanging tree that comes right into the water. Also with some lily beds there, and just over to the right, the same sort of scenario, a tree that hangs right into the water. So, and they're the sort of things you're looking for, trees in the water, lilies, roots, anything that they can hide and get away, because at the end of the day, perch are predatory fish. They're going to sit there in ambush, wait for something to come past, and then it's whack, they're going to be smashing it. So anywhere where they can sit and hide is ideal for perch fishing, and this swim looks ideal. So let's get on to a little bit of the baits before we show you the rigs. Now, as I said, perch realistically are predatory fish in a natural habitat, but over the years everyone knows that they're really partial to the odd lobworm, and you can catch them on normal baits like maggots and stuff like that. So we're going to try and catch them on normal baits, not live baits today, but we want to get something there to try and get them interested to start with. So initially in here, all I've got is just some molehill soil just from up the bank there. That's been riddled, so there's no lumps or stones in it. Just a bit of grass in there, but that'll come out. And that's just going to be like a little carrier for a few bit of goodies and that. Now, hook bait wise, we've got two options. First of all, the big common lobworm. There's a few in here if I dig these out for you. I mean, they're going to be great just to be hooking hole through the saddle and a great little perch bait. But we'll show you more about that later. But what we've done is we've chopped a few of those up. So we've got a few lobworm sections. They're going to go into here just for try and get an initial bit of interest into the swim, so we'll mix those in a bit. Also going in there, we've got a little pot of dead maggots, just all sorts of mixtures of colours. That's going to do two things. It's going to attract a few little fish into the swim, which hopefully obviously in turn is going to bring some perch in, and obviously perch themselves, they don't mind a bit of maggot as well, so that's all just going to be enticing them in. Now the last thing we're going to add is actually some prawns. Now these are brilliant perch bait, normally quite expensive but quite cheap here on Water's Edge. We've got a bit of on offer, so we've got a tub of these, and I'm just going to chop just a few tiny little segments in there, and that's just because we're going to have probably one on worm today and one on prawn, so it's just giving us a few different options. And we know there's quite a few other fish in here, so we may get pest a little bit fishing worm by eyed and big roach and stuff like that, so hopefully by fishing prawn we may eliminate that and have one definite perch rod fishing. So that's going to be the idea behind that. So I mean, that's just going to be a lovely little mix of all sorts of goodies that perch like. And then finally, to add into it, we've got some Predator Plus liquid. Now this is really good for any predatory fish. It's vibrant red in color, so first of all, it's what they're going to be looking for. Wounded fish, blood, that's going to be right what they're looking for. So you can see in there how vibrant it is. So I'm going to put a good squirt of that in there. Smells really good as well. Anything predatory, this is going to attract them. So I'm going to try and give that a mix. Try not to get my hands in there too much because it's a very strong colour, and you'll turn your hands pretty red straight away. And already that Predator Plus and then prawns are smelling really fishy. So hopefully the perch are going to like that. So there we are. We're just going to put, I don't know, 3 or 4 balls of those into each swim. Try not to make too much noise, but you want to get something in there to attract them. So what I'll do is I'll put a bit of this in now. We'll come back up and we'll have a look at the rigs because they're also just as important. Right, we're just going to get a few balls this in swim. Like I said, not many. I don't know, 3 or 4 maybe. And not really particularly in a concentrated area, just in the sort of area where we're going to be fishing. Under underhanging tree, near them lilies. That should be a good spot to ambush a few perch. So, not very big. I want to try and keep a little bit quiet, but we'll get a few of these in. Right, well that's just about to do it. While we're letting that settle, what we'll do is we'll take one of the rigs up to the shelter and we'll talk you through a bit about the rigs we're using for today. Right, okay, just while we let that settle, we'll have a little look at the rig as we said. First of all, the rod we've got a 12 foot specimen, 1.25 pound test curve rod. Now they're nice and soft, so they're gonna be nice for these perch underneath the rod tip. 6 pound line, don't want nothing too big. Like I said, perch as a general rule don't go massive, so you're not got to worry about catching 5-6 pound perch all the while. So you can go a little bit lighter on the rigs than normal. Now coming down to the business end, this is the rig bit which you need to be quite important for perch. Now the main thing to I can give you tip wise for perch, and the one thing if you're going to take anything away from this, is that you need to have no resistance. If perch feel any sort of resistance at all, they're going to pick the bait up and just drop it straight away. So the least resistance you can get, the more chance you've got of catching a fish. I really can't emphasize that enough. Now then, with that in mind, obviously we've got a large running ring on the line. This lead is just completely free running all the way up just to a running rig system. So that is just going to be no resistance at all. If a perch picks that bait up, that lead is going to slide away and they're not going to feel anything, hopefully before it's too late and the hook's in. Again, to try and minimise resistance, we've got quite a long hook link. Now again, if you had a short little hook link there, before it's picked up, it's going to feel something, it's just going to get rid of it and you're going to struggle to hook. They've got quite bony mouths, so they are frustrating sometimes to hook, and anything you can do to try and enhance that is going to help your chances throughout the day. So quite a long hook link. And then obviously to match that, we've got a relatively large hook. Once they do pick a bait up, you want it to go in and stay in. You don't want to be losing fish, especially finicky fish that are hard to hook in the first place. So like I said, keep it nice and free running. There is another bit to make it even more free running, which we'll show you when we're setting the rod, but as a general rule, free running rigs and fairly long hook links. Obviously there's many other ways you can do it with float fish and stuff like that. We're only showing you one way today, so hopefully you can take something away from this as well. So let's get this one baited. Now we're gonna have one and one. First rod we'll put out will just be on worm. The second rod we'll probably put a little bit of prawn segment on. So hooking these worms, now with lobworm, they're fairly easy really. You don't really want to thread it on a hook like a lugworm if you were sea fishing. There's got a saddle, which I don't know if you can see on camera, but you certainly will if you pick one up. And realistically, you just want to be hooking through that and coming out the other side and leaving some hook points showing. So there's a nice big bait there, and obviously said, catching point there with your hook. So that's going to catch anything that comes and gulfs that. Hopefully with no resistance, they're not going to be worried about feeling it. So big baits, big mouths, and hopefully big fish, but that bit's still yet to come. So I'm going to flick this out now and we'll get that rod set, and one final tip to show you. Well, that rod's in there nicely, just up against that tree where we're baiting now. The next bit is relatively important while you're perch fishing as well. I'm just going to try and stay a little bit quieter because obviously we're a bit closer to the water now. So first thing to do is get your line sunk. If you just follow me down here to the rod rest. Now this is what I was saying about the least resistance possible. First thing is you may notice everything is pointing directly at that rig. So this rod is pointing towards this tree and the other rod's actually behind me, completely away from each other, pointing exactly where you're casting. So again, there's no resistance pulling either way on your quiver tip. It's all directly in front of it. So just tighten up roughly as tight as you can. Sorry about the train going past. And then you want to, rather than having your bait runner on, what I actually like to do is probably show you the most expensive bit of fishing tackle I own. It's actually just a little twig off the floor, to be honest. And all I'm doing is just going to wind that round the spool, and then to keep it tight, obviously to bait runner, I'm just going to lay that twig on the line, and that will just give it enough tension to go through to your bait runner. So once that's on there, you got your alarm on. And you should be all set, ready to go. So it's all nice and slack, that little bit of tension there. As soon as anything pulls that twig, it's going to fall off and it should be completely free riding, but your indication is going to come from your bite alarm. So it's nice and free, but sensitive as well. Let's get the other rod done as well. Well, that rod's fishing nicely. It's all set, pointing directly at it. So I know I kept going on about it, but this resistance is so important. On that one, we've got worms. So on this one, we're just going to put a bit of prawn. Now, I've just chopped the bigger bit off, just purely so it's not just a huge bait. I mean, we might try and put a bigger bit on later if we feel like there's some bigger fish in it. But like I said, we don't really know the size. So there we are. It's just going to be, it's not casting anywhere. So it literally is just a nick through the tail end. And you've got a lovely big perch bait. Now, as I said, there's quite a few other fish in here, so hopefully if we're getting pestered on worm by like eyed and stuff like that, this will stop that. And perch absolutely love prawns, so this could be the winner. But I'm just gonna get that flicked out again. This rod's gonna be pointing in that direction. We'll get this out there and we'll see what unfolds. Well, we just had a run on that prawn rod. It didn't really tear away, but it just sort of ticked off the, yeah, it is a perch. We just got them down here. As I say, it didn't really tear off, it just sort of flicked that twig off and then sort of slowly went away, but chuffed with that. First perch of the session. Let's get him in, see if we can have a look at him. We've got a nice mat down here, so just nicely hooked in the side. First one falls to the prawn, as I said. They seem to love that, but you can see why they're a predatory fish. They're just molded perfection, really. They got that spiky dorsal thing. Be careful if you've never held perch before. That is very, very sharp, but again, it's just protection for them. Nothing's gonna come in and grab that. It's gonna get pricked by the top there. They've also got red fins, but the best thing is just this camouflage. You've got the stripes across there. I mean, if that's just gonna sit there in the edge, that is the perfect ambush predator. And the last thing that probably a little roach sees is that huge mouth. A bit like a bass, they've just got huge mouths. And whatever comes in front of it, if it's small enough, it's going in there. Cracking start. I don't know, he may make a pound, maybe not quite, but chuffed with that, only been fishing a few minutes. Well, we've been fishing now for about half an hour or so. That's like, so we had that, as you see, that nice perch at the start, really a short while into the session. Since then, we've had a couple of really small ones, but nothing really to report for the camera. I am just gonna now slowly just introduce a few lob sections and the odd bit of chunk of prawn just for a catapult while I sit back here and stay quiet out of the way. I'm just gonna just flick these over both the rods just to keep getting like a bit of a smell in the water, bit of attract in there. Probably put a few maggots over there as well, try and get a few roach and that feeding. That always entices predatory fish to come out if they see a bit of a frenzy. So just trying to get another bite. We're just gonna flick little bits of bait over each spot. Just trying to keep that activity going, really. You wanna give them a reason to come out of the hiding hole and pick your bait up. So hopefully you're doing that. Shouldn't be too long before we have another fish. Secretly, I'm really hoping for a 2-pounder today. I don't know if I'm gonna get it, but that's what I came out here to do today. So just gonna sit back now for a little while, keep that bait going in, and we'll see what happens. Well, we've got another fish on the prawn. I'm not entirely convinced this one's a perch. It ran off a bit quick and putting up a bit of a scrap. They don't tend to fight too much, the perch, but it's certainly giving me a bit of grief. It's actually an eel. Well, I suppose eels do like the same sort of stuff as what we've fed for the perch. To be honest, I'm not too pleased about this. I'm not a massive fan of eels, to be honest with you. Ooh, break your net in half as well. Right, let's see if we can get the hook out. I mean, eels are notorious for swallowing your hook. So I'm just gonna use my net to grab him because they are an absolute pain to get hold of. Whee. Try and twist round your arm. Right, let's get him back in that net. Right, I've got him. Let's see if we can get this hook out. I don't think I'm going to be able to pick him up and show you, but to be honest with you, they're a little bit of an endangered species. You don't see too many eels about now, and he's not the smallest eel I've ever caught. Like I said, they're probably not one of my favourite fish. And I haven't caught one for a while, but there's a river not far by. And if you don't know, like eels, they do go across land and water. So you almost sort of find them everywhere. And as well as perch, they are a predatory fish. Very, very strong and slippery. Swim backwards as well. So quite an interesting fish, to be honest with you. Not the prettiest, and probably not just me who isn't too keen on him, but we're not going to spoil his day. And I guess it's the first eel we've had on From Water's Edge cameras, but we'll send him back on his way. At least we've caught something. And he's off. Oh well, let's see if we can get a perch. Well, we seem to be catching an awful lot of perch, but we've got one on the other one as well. But they all seem to be a lot smaller than expected. we can show you this one. Jumping around a bit. No. At least it shows that what we're doing is working, but to be honest, these fish are a little bit too small. They're probably not quite a pound. Well, this one is probably even smaller than that. See if I can just nip that hook out. But if there's one thing, it's definitely shown that the rigs are working right. These have all been really hooked well. Had to use the disgorgers for most of them. But like I said, they're all sort of peas in a pod at this size, really. We can't seem to catch anything bigger. And I did say at the start, we don't know if there's any bigger fish in here. So it may just be the fact that these fellas are the sort of size that's in here. But they're cracking little fish. And I don't know, we've probably had 10 or 12 of them. We haven't felt the need to show you them because we thought we were going to get bigger fish, but that may not be the case. So perhaps we'll show you a couple of these little fellas. It's just nice to see such a well-tuned predator close up. See if we can have a few more. Well, I've hooked something else on the worm. I don't think, again, this is a perch. It's turned into be some perch fishing video. But it's fighting a bit too hard, I think, to be a perch. I might be wrong, and I hope I'm wrong. I hope it's a huge perch, but I would be surprised. And fishing worm, that's actually quite a relatively nice sized carp. But like I said, fishing worm, you do sort of leave yourself open to that in a mixed fishery, in the fact that anything will take it. And then that prawn rod has literally just been perch on there. Like I said, we've had quite a few, but nothing of any size. But we might as well show you this anyway. He's done well to get it in there. He's got a little bit of a deformed mouth. Slip that hook out. Yeah, you can see the lob worm on there. Let's have a look at him. Ooh. As I said, not a perch. If he was, he'd be a British record, but never mind. We're still on a bank catching fish. As I said, some perch fishing, eh? Let's pop him back. Another fish coming towards the net. It is another little perch. Well, I say little, they go a lot smaller than this, but it's the sort of size that we've been catching all day, really. They've probably been just under a pound as an average. The first fish we had was probably slightly bigger, just over a pound maybe, but this just seems to be the size that they all are. I mean, we were a bit unexpected and perhaps a little bit too hopeful that there was going to be a real beast in there. I'm not saying that there isn't, and perhaps there is. I mean, perhaps if you were to come live bait fishing or something like that, then you might catch a bigger perch doing it that way. But I mean, being predominantly a match angler, I'm not a massive fan of live baiting, so we thought we'd catch them like on worms and prawns and stuff like that. And don't get me wrong, we've had a great day. I've had loads of these that we haven't shown you, just for in danger of being a bit repetitive of ourselves. But it's just been hopefully enjoyable for you, and certainly shows that the rigs we're using works with the finesse and the free running rigs. It definitely does catch perch, whatever's there. I mean, even if they're not the biggest, if it's catching fellas this size, it will catch fish bigger than this as well. So we'll slip this one back. As always, thanks for watching. I hope the tips you've seen today put some big perch in the bank in your local lakes. And we'll see you again on the next one.